Okay, here I am. I made it. I'm at True North. I checked in today. Everybody's really nice. The people who are fasting, there's people who are fasting, people who are just here for health education, and they're eating all raw food. And then raw, vegetables and quinoa. Not completely raw. Some cooked. And then there's people who are on their way out, so they're in the refeeding process. People who are fasting, you walk in and you can notice them right away because they're laying down. They're kind of meandering, like slowly looking around, like almost like tripping out, And then you say hi, and they go like that. I have two roommates. They're older. One is she must be in her 70s, and she has an autoimmune disease. She's very talkative and very friendly. This is her third time here. She used to be 300 pounds. She's not 300 pounds anymore. In the last 2 years, she's just been healing herself. I can't remember her name, but I'll find out and I'll let you know. She's very talkative, which is interesting because she's so tired from not eating, from fasting. For 11 days, she's on day 11. She's going to be here for 30, fasting for 30. The only thing is she likes to sit in the dark. And so we have like a, this is like a suite, and then there's a living room, three bedrooms off of that. They share a bathroom, and I have my own bathroom. And she just, this fast, she said she's been sitting in the dark. So she doesn't have a TV in her room, and so she's been watching the one out in the living room. And so kind of makes me a little like depressed to see someone sitting watching TV in the dark like that during the day. Although I understand it because at my sickest, the sunlight was so too much on my eyes. It hurt, and it felt so good to be in a dark room. And she's got something going on with her eyes, and so I get it. But I did mention to the front desk, like, I'm not so sure how I'm gonna feel. Maybe I'll feel like her in a few days where I'll want to be sitting in the dark, but for now, we'll just wait and see. So they know that I maybe will want to move if I get too, like, depressed or whatever with that. But like I said, maybe I'll feel like doing that. I immediately regret not bringing one of my dogs because I did not know that you could take a dog here, and you can. So I regret not bringing Squash. Although you do have to pay for your own place, which is more. I'm sharing this suite, but the other ones that are for dogs, you have to pay for the whole thing unless you have other people who have dogs, I guess. Also, the dogs can't pee in the suite. They have to be house trained and they're not supposed to bark, which could be a problem for squash monsters. Well, anyhow, I wish I had my dog. I had two juices today. So I got here today. I had two juices before I got on the plane. And then I had water, water, water. Actually, not that much water. I'm lying. I should have had more water. But I got here and just planned on doing water for the rest of the day. But they're doing some blood tests on me tomorrow morning. And so they wanted me to eat something. And so there was a dinner. And they have, it's just all vegetables, quinoa. The vegetable soup is literally vegetable soup. There's no salt on anything. The spices, they're just ground up spices. it was very good and very refreshing and clean food. It did feel good to eat some beets, though, because I feel like I needed iron. I haven't eaten meat in, probably 10 days at least. I have had some nuts and vegetables and things like that over the course of the last 10 days. But because they're all vegan here, I just thought, well, let me just clean off the meat for a little while. And I did do juicing, and then I would have vegetables at night. But even with juicing, because there's so much sugar, I felt like I gained weight in those 10 days leading up to this fast. I just never have that much sugar, so that was pretty interesting. Sometimes I couldn't even finish all the juices that I was supposed to drink in a day. But yeah, so far, here I am, day one. Like I said, I regret not bringing my dog just for comfort because I feel lonely. I do feel lonely. This is my first time away from my kids, which is hard. Never been away from them, so that's hard. And but I'm here, and I'm gonna try to do everything I can to get better. And I do believe in this process because I've read a lot about it, and they have so many DVDs here for you to learn more about it, and they have classes, and they have cooking classes if you're here to completely change your lifestyle. So hopefully I can keep myself busy enough so I won't be thinking about food all the time. I can see the next few days being a little difficult because I was actually really hungry today. And so wish me luck. I'm going to try to do these every day. I will let you know what goes on tomorrow. And hopefully I'll have some funny stories to tell about some of the people walking around in daisies or anything else. Thank you so much for everybody who has said that they support me and that they believe that I can do this. I appreciate it. That means everything to me. Thank you for everybody also for helping out with my kids. Appreciate it. Like, you don't even know. So, that said, I will see you tomorrow.